In this video, we will see how to define multiple doses in a dataset read by the Monolix suite. Let's begin with an example. Here, an individual receives 5 bolus doses every 24 hours from time 0 with some observations after the first dose and one observation just before each of the other doses. One way to encode these multiple doses in the dataset is with round robin dose, as can be seen here. The dataset contains 5 doses of the same amount. These doses can also be encoded equivalently with a single line with the help of two columns of type additional doses and interdose interval, as we can see here. The line contains the first dose at time 0. In addition, the value 4 in the column additional doses means that 4 doses will be added afterward, and the value 24 in the column interdose interval means that the doses will be given every 24 hours. Instead of defining additional doses after some dose, it is also possible to define additional doses before some dose, with the column type steady state. Let's look at another example to explain what is the use of this column. Here, a patient takes regularly oral doses at home. Then, during a hospital visit, they get a dose at site measured at time 0, and several post-dose PK measurements. The goal is to measure observations at steady state, meaning when any transitory effect is over and the response is a periodic function of doses. In this case, it is more convenient to define the multiple doses based on the time of the last dose, here 0, with multiple doses before that time that allow to reach a steady state. So one way to encode this would be like the dataset here with one line per dose. The dose at site is at time 0, followed by the observations. This dataset can be encoded equivalently with two columns of type steady state and interdose interval, like on this dataset. The steady state flag on the dose row means that a fixed number of doses with the same amount are added before this dose. By default, the number is 5, so there are 6 doses in total, but it can be changed in the interface. The period between doses is set to the interdose interval, here 24 hours. Note that there can be only one column with the type steady state in the dataset, as well as only one column additional doses. Both columns should always be combined with a column of the type interdose interval. So remember that the number of doses to add can be changed here and will be saved in the project file. Then it is up to me to check, for example, on the individual fit that the number of doses is sufficient to reach the steady state for this individual. This is because using the steady state column does not consist in using the analytical solution at steady state for an infinity of doses, but only adds some multiple doses before the time of the line. Note also that if your structural model is defined with ODEs, you have to be careful of the integration time because additional doses that fall before that time will actually not be added. Moreover, contrary to the doses added with the column additional doses, with steady state, if the doses to add interfere with another dose or observation, the number of added doses will be reduced compared to the specified value. This is what we can see. In this example, which is the same as before but with an observation just before the dose given at site at time 0. So as indicated in this warning message that appears after loading the data, the multiple doses taken at home before the visit to the hospital and encoded as previously with steady state at time 0 are actually not added. This would be the case even if the line corresponding to this observation was ignored in the dataset. Now what happens if the system is not at initial values when doses are added? For example, in this project, a first dose is given at time 0, followed by some measurements. Then a dose is given at time 10 with a tag steady state with an interdose interval of 3.5. So additional doses are also given before time 10. On the plots for individual 1, we can see that although 5 additional doses are specified in the interface, only 2 additional doses fit between the first observations and time 10. In addition, there is a washout just before the first additional dose, meaning that the system is reset to the initial value, which is 0 here. This plot is recalled on the top of this slide along with the dataset. Now, if I replace the tag 1 by 2 in the column steady state, as on the bottom, the same 2 additional doses are added, but without washout. To summarize, the possible values that can be given in the column steady state are 0 for no additional dose, 1 for additional doses with washout before the first added doses, and 2 or 3 for additional doses without washout. The column steady state can be combined with the column event ID. If event ID has a value 3 or 4, it defines a washout just before the dose on the same line, here at time 10. Even if there is a tag on the steady state column, there is no washout before the additional doses. However, if the tag is 1, there is a washout just before the first additional dose, here at time 3. It is important to note that the interpolation of regressor values is different when using additional doses or steady state columns. On this example dataset, doses have been added with the column steady state and with the column additional doses, and the column reg is used as a regressor. We can see on the equivalent dataset on the right that lines added due to the steady state columns get the same regressor value as the line with the steady state statement, here 2. In contrast, lines added due to the additional doses columns are interpolated based on the value at the previous time, which is different here for the two additional doses at time 14 and 16. You can find more information on dataset encoding for monolix on our documentation website dataset.lixof.com.